Does anyone else hate carrying their golf clubs? In this video, I'm unboxing the Motocaddy M7 Remote. Should make walking on the golf course a whole lot easier. Let's get into it. What's up, golfers? Welcome back to New Nine Golf. It's your boy, Brandon. And before we start testing the Motocaddy M7 Remote, we gotta do some unboxing. If you're not a fan of unboxing, I'm gonna put chapters in the description below so you can skip ahead till we do the on-course testing. Not a problem. For those that wanna watch the unboxing, let's get into it. The first thing that's out of the box that you can see is this new bag by Motocaddy. It is the HydroFlex bag. What's really cool about this bag is on the bottom of the bag, there's two pegs that will actually fit into the Motocaddy M7 remote, which pretty much eliminates the need for a bottom strap. Most of these carts have a strap at the top and a strap at the bottom, but if you go with the Motocaddy bag on the Motocaddy M7 remote, all you gotta do is click it in. I'm really excited to figure that out. So let's get that thing out of the box. Okay guys, so you should know that this Motocaddy M7 remote is about $2,000 Canadian or $1,550 US, which seems to be like a pretty decent benchmark for a lot of high quality electric trolleys. The one thing I do want to tell you guys, if you are considering getting an electric trolley, is to not cheap out. So I made the mistake about a year and a half ago that I wanted my first electric trolley and I decided to cheap out. I went with the no name. I found these guys on a local buy sell page. They repped a company that I'm pretty sure that they just private labeled from Asia. It was like 700 bucks, 800 bucks. It was good for like two or three rounds. But ever since I got my hands on real electric trolleys, like the Motocaddy product, it's not even close. So if you're considering buying one, just don't cheap out. Okay, let's get this thing out of the box. Okay, I assume that is battery. This is gonna be our third wheel, or fourth wheel, I guess, the stability wheel. Instructions, a remote, a bag strap, a USB charger. The body. The wheels. Is there anything else? That's it. Okay, let's start assembling. So just so you know, this is an instructional video on how to build it, so I'm not gonna go through how I'm building it. I'm gonna assemble it, then I'll start talking about the features, and then at the end of the video, I'm gonna take it to the course to show you how it really performs in a real golf scenario. Okay, so we got the Motocaddy M7 remote assembled, and it was pretty easy once I figured it out. Thank God for instructions, because without them, I was wandering aimlessly. This battery I wanted to point out really quick is so far the most unique battery that I've seen on electric golf push carts. It's just a different shape. So it looks like there's two sides of the battery that will go in and then this will plug into the remote. It's not good or bad, I just wanted to point out that it looks different and it's not too heavy. One of the most annoying things about especially inexpensive push trolleys or electric trolleys is the weight of the battery. This I bet is under 10 pounds. So fairly light, which so far is a good thing. So I did also get the Motocaddy accessory pack. It's gonna come with a phone or GPS holder, a water bottle holder, umbrella holder, and a scorecard holder. So I'll get these out and I'll put them on the M7. That was easy. That was easy. Okay, so all the accessories are on. The last thing to do is to just mount the bag. I was telling you earlier about the bag. Has this easy lock system. That is these two metal dots at the bottom of the bag. So I'm like, does it clip in? I have no idea. So because I'm using a Motocaddy bag on the Motocaddy M7 remote, there's no need for me to use the bottom strap. If you pick up an M7 remote and you don't have a Motocaddy bag, it does come with the bottom strap. So you can still assemble it at the bottom if you wanted to, but since the Easy Lock is on it, this bag ain't going anywhere because those hooks in the Easy Lock are what's keeping it in. So far, what I really like about this combo between the Motocaddy HydroFlex bag and the M7 remote is that up until now, I haven't found a single stand bag that fits comfortably on an electric trolley. There's always problems with the bottom kickstand or the top where the legs are, where this is a light carry bag and it fits onto the M7 remote perfectly. Obviously, it's the same company, it's made for each other, but in all of my trials in other brands, I haven't found that yet. So far, I love that feature. So when I put the bag onto the M7 remote, the bag sits flush. So even though it has a kickstand and legs on it, you can see it's curved, which helps to sit flush. For other bags that are straight, there's always a gap, which is never fun because that's what moves your bag around. So this HydroFlex bag sits perfect on the M7 remote, even though it's a carry bag. Okay, so I've got this thing out of the box, I got it assembled, and I got my bag, the HydroFlex Motocaddy bag, onto the M7 remote. I haven't turned it on yet, and I don't even know if there's any juice in the battery, but we're gonna find out. I'm gonna walk you just through some things that I see so far. So the wheels on it, there's two big wheels at the base, and these look to be like all-terrain wheels, that there are some ribs, they're not just flat. So if you're going over hills, bumps, dirt, I suspect these are gonna hold up just fine. The front has two wheels and they turn on an axis. I've seen some bags before where the front wheels don't move, it's just the rear wheels pushing it. This, I imagine, is gonna turn really well because the front wheels swivel. There's also a, I guess it's the fifth wheel in the back, and this is your stability wheel. It's great for when you're going up hills. It's supposed to keep your bag steady and avoid it from tipping over, but we'll find out on the course. Okay, now that I'm on the steering end of the Motocaddy, I see that there is battery power. It is on. The LCD screen has turned on. Before I get there, I want to talk about the accessories. The accessories were so easy to assemble. So again, it came with a scorecard holder, so that screwed right into the Motocaddy. There is a cell phone holder or a GPS holder, whatever you want to put on here. There's an umbrella holder and then a water bottle holder. So all of these seem to be good quality and they hooked up super easy. It was very simple to assemble all of these, very simple. So now that I'm at the handle, I am familiar with this because I've seen other Motocaddy electric trolleys. There's two ways to steer or move this electric caddy. The first way is with the remote. So it comes with a nice little remote with very simple, straightforward buttons. It has your up, down, left, right, stop, and power. This doesn't take any batteries, doesn't take a AAA or a AA. It is a rechargeable battery. So you'll just have to take this home with you, plug it in. It comes with a charger. If this dies or you don't want to use it, you can put it into manual mode. So there's only one button on the Motocaddy M7 remote and it has a dial. So if I turn the dial to the right, it'll go from 1 to 9. Those are my speeds. 1 being the slowest, 9 being the fastest. If I wanted to move it, all I do is push down and it'll start moving it. The 1 setting is obviously quite slow, and if you start it at 9, again, it's gonna take off, but you can play around with the speeds that you want on the course, which I'm going to test once we get there. So one more thing that I noticed is right on the handle, it says USB charge. So underneath our handle, there is a USB port that you can use as a charging device. So hypothetically, if you had your phone on the phone holder and the battery's almost dead, you could plug the USB into the cart and then plug that into your phone and it's gonna charge your phone. That's really cool and I haven't seen that on any other remote caddies. So what I wanna do before I take this onto the course is I wanna see how it fits into my car. I'll take my bag off and then I'll fold down the M7 remote and see how it fits in my car, then I'll go to the course. All right, I've got this thing folded up. It folds quite well. I've seen other electric trolleys fold up better, but it is still quite compact and maybe it just looks bigger because I have all the accessories on it. So from here, I'm gonna throw it in my car. Okay, so we got the M7 remote into my trunk. I have an SUV, obviously, so it is quite easy. If you had a small compact car, I'm sure you could get it to fit in there. So there are a couple more things that I could do to make this more compact if I needed. Some things I could do is I could take off the accessories. So we're gonna limit some space taking those off. And I can also invert these wheels. These wheels will come out and I can reverse them, which will make them even smaller. But because I have the luxury of an SUV and I wanna basically get to the course, open it up, I'm not gonna go through doing all of that. All right, now that we're locked and loaded, I'll meet you guys at the golf course. All right, guys, we made it to the course. I've played about 3 holes now with the M7, and overall, the impressions are great. So far in using the M7 remote, it feels really good. The remote itself is extremely responsive. What I love about this is if I want it to turn left or right, it turns with no problem at all. In using it down the fairways, it's extremely smooth and it doesn't wander offline, which is a big pet peeve I've found in other push carts. It holds its line quite true and it feels really good. One thing that we're gonna do to test this is test it on some hills. So we're gonna test an incline and a decline and we'll see how it does. That's a pretty good test. So that was a pretty good uphill test. I'm out of breath already. But the fact that it handled that and I didn't have to touch it and I could just use the remote, awesome test. The course that I play here is Country Hills in Calgary, Alberta. And the first hole to get there is a huge steep incline. Driving this on steep inclines is so easy. I've had others that are super finicky. This will go off of the front wheel, and even steering it going left and right while the front wheel is up handles with ease. What I haven't done is tested it downhill. So why don't I send this downhill and we can see how it reacts. So this is about a 45 degree angle and we'll see how it handles down here. Overall, that was super smooth. I don't know why I was anticipating something to go wrong, but clearly it didn't. So handles well. If I wanted to stop, I just press that button. I can walk up and catch up to it. But overall, the handling's been really great so far. So if I had to really critique this and find things that I don't like, there's one thing that I don't like, and it's kind of about electric carts in general, is that they don't give you a net or any type of storage pouch that even with the accessory kit, there's nothing for me to put my cell phone or my keys or a sweater, those types of things. I wish that they would just invent some type of net, because when I use a push cart, they have obviously a big cargo net. So that's one thing that I don't love not having. Another thing I noticed is the water bottle holder didn't fit my big water bottle, which is like such a small critique. It'll fit fine for like a, obviously like a normal water bottle from the store, like Coca-Cola, Pepsi, those types of bottles. It just didn't fit my big water bottle. And that's again, a really small knack. But overall, the accessories and the carts so far have been really good. So if I want the M7 to come back to me, there is a reverse. I just have to hold this back or this minus button. I do have to hold it. I can't just press it and then hit stop. And then if I put it into manual mode where I'm no longer using the remote, I'm just pushing it. There's not really a good way that I've found yet to pull this back because there is a lot of tension on the wheels. So I'll have to keep looking around and see if there's a different way to use reverse, but I find the best way is to just use the remote and hold that back button. I really wanna show you guys how well this thing steers. So I'm gonna bring it up to the green and I'll show you how I maneuver it around the green. So far, parking this thing around greens has been awesome. Because that remote is so responsive, I could get it basically on the first cut or on that apron, drive it around the entire green, and I can park it in the direction that I'm headed next. So I really enjoy driving this up near the greens. So something that I have noticed is when I drive the M7 on grass, it's extremely quiet. As soon as I get it onto the pavement, it's pretty noisy. So I might have to play around with either the wheels or the accessories and find out what's making the noise, but that's what I noticed just in my first round using it, is that it is pretty noisy on the cart path. So going up the hill, it made it. It struggled a little bit. There was a little bit of a wheel slip. What is cool about Motocaddy is they have a very established accessory line. So if I wanted, I could get the all-terrain wheels, which would add just a little bit more grip. They also make like a seat. They make a full cover, a mitt. Even though I got just these normal basic accessories, there's a lot more things that I could buy to assemble onto the M7. So one of the things that's cool about the M7 is the battery life. The battery life will get minimum 36 holes on one charge, which is awesome. You can play a full 18, not have to take battery in and charge it, just to get a full round. So that's what they're saying on average is what you'll get. Okay guys, in wrapping up, the Motocaddy M7 remote is an awesome electric trolley. It's so easy to use. With this being my first round, I'm extremely comfortable with it. The remote is awesome, handles wicked on the course. It's great on uphills, downhills, it turns on a dime. There's not a lot going against it. I would 100% recommend this. I myself would pick one up. I would give one to any one of my golfing friends or family. Overall, 100% a great electric trolley. Thank you so much for watching this review. If you haven't already, make sure you smash subscribe, give this video a like, and we'll check in with you next time. See you later, guys.